Hi students, today we discuss about the one more chapter of the third standard, that is measurements. Dear student, in the measurements chapter we can learn the measurement of length, measurement of weight, measurement of volume, and finally the measurement of time. There are four concepts present in the chapter measurements. Dear students, only the little information in your third standard, you can learn more about the measurements for your higher sections. Okay. Dear students, first we discuss the measurement of length. Okay. First we learn the measurement of length. We can use mainly for your syllabus three units, that is millimeter, centimeter and meter, and kilometer is also one of the unit for measuring the length. For your syllabus you only learn only millimeter, centimeter and meter. These are the three units we can use to measure the length of the objects. The first one is, that is millimeter. Millimeter, it is denoted as m. Dear student, millimeter is denoted as a small letter m. m means it is a millimeter. Millimeter. Dear students, millimeter, it is used to measure very short length. The millimeter is used to measure very short length. Dear students, we can use millimeter unit only for very short length measurement. We can use millimeter. Example, I show with an example. Dear student, we can use the measurement unit millimeter in the short length measurement, that is the thickness of the paper. For example, the thickness of the paper. The thickness of the paper is very small. Okay. So it is in, say, we can say in millimeter. Okay. The thickness of the paper we can say in millimeter. And also the thickness of your textbook. Okay, dear student, this is your maths textbook. We can measure the thickness of the textbook. It is also in millimeter. Dear students, we can use millimeter to measuring very short length. For example, the thickness of the paper, the thickness of the notebook, or thickness of the textbook, or thickness of any other objects we can use to measure the unit, that is millimeter. Did you understand, student? Then the next unit, that is centimeter. Dear student, centimeter is also one of the unit we can measure length. Centimeter. It is also one of the unit we can use to measure the length of the object. The centimeter is denoted as a cm. Okay. It's not a capital letter. It is also in small letter. Cm. Cm is denoting of centimeter. Cm means centimeter. When we use centimeter, dear student, the centimeter is used to measure short length or short height. We can use centimeter in case of short length measurement or short height measurement. Dear student, we can use to measure the short length objects and also short height objects. We can use centimeter. For example, short length means we can use to measure the length of your pen. The length of pen, pencil, notebook, etc. Or the length of the duster, length of the chalk piece, length of the blackboard, or in these cases we can use the centimeter. So short length measurement we can use centimeter. Then short height, short height measurement we can also use centimeter. That is the example for the measurement of height of the table. Height of the table, chair, etc. Height of the chair, height of the table, height of the TV, height of the wall. All these cases we can use centimeter. Centimeter is also used to measure short length and also short height. This is the small information about centimeter. Then meter. Dear student, then go to the meter scale. Meter is also another measuring unit of the length. That is meter. It is denoted as a small letter M. Meter is also another unit of measurement of a length. We can denote this one in a small letter M. When we use meter, meter is used for measuring long length or long height and also short distance. Short distance. Dear students, the meter is used to measuring a long length, long height and also short distance. In these three situations we can use the measuring unit, that is meter. Okay, the first one, the measurement of long length example. The long length means the length of the room. Length of room, length of the bus, length of the car, etc. All these cases we can use to measure meter. Okay, then second one, the long height. We can use to measuring the height of the tree. Height of tree and height of building. Height of the building, height of the tree. In these situations, we can use the measuring unit, that is meter. Okay, then last one is this short distance. Dear students, we can also use meter for measuring a short distance. Short distance means, for example, the distance between your room to kitchen. Okay, dear students, the distance between in your home, the distance between your bedroom to kitchen. These two having a very short distance. In these situations, we can use the measuring unit, that is meter. The distance between the two rooms, or the distance between your bedroom to kitchen, or your bedroom to hall. These are having a very short distance. In these cases, we can use the measuring unit, that is meter. Okay, so this is the measurement of length. We can use the three different types of measuring unit, that is millimeter, centimeter and meter. The millimeter is used to measure very short length, and centimeter is used to measure short length and also short height. The meter is used to measure the long length, long height, and also short distance. The one more unit is there, that is kilometer. Kilometer is also one of the measuring unit of the length. It is, we can use kilometer for a long distance. For example, the distance between the two cities. Okay, so you learn more information about kilometer for your next class. Okay, next class means your higher standard. Okay, so we continue the class. The next one is the measurement of weight. The second one is measurement of weight. Before we go into measurement of weight, we learn the relationship between the measurement of length. That is one relation between centimeter and meter. Dear students, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. This is the relationship between meter and centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter are together to called as a 1 meter, or 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. This is the relationship between the centimeter and meter. You study more about and more calculation for the conversion of units for your higher standard. Okay, then going to the next concept, that is measurement of weight. Dear students, the measurement of weight, this is the second concept in this chapter. Measurement of weight. Dear students, the measurement of weight, you already learned the weight of the different objects having a different weights. Okay, so the weights of the object is varies from one object to another. For example, the weight of your weights or your friend weights are also varies from one person to another person. Dear students, in the weight measurements, we can mainly use, there are two standard units of measurement of a weight. That is, the first one is gram and second one is kilogram. Dear student, these two are the two standard units of measurement of a weight. The first one is the gram and second one is the kilogram. Dear student, gram is one of the measuring unit of a weight. It is used to measure the small, this is one of the small weighing unit. Dear student, the gram is used to measure the small quantity of the objects, and kilogram is used to measure the large quantity of the object. For example, the gram is denoted as a small letter g, and the kilogram is denoted as a kg. Okay, the gram is used to measure the less weight object or the small quantity of object, and kilogram is used to measure the heavy quantity of object or big quantity or big objects. Okay, so dear students, the for example gram. Dear student, in your home, your mom purchased some of the things. Dear students, the pumpkin, it is having a very heavy weight. Okay, heavy weight, it is having a more weight as compared to one onion. As compared to one onion and also one pumpkin, which one is the less and which one is the more weight? Dear students, the one onion having a less weight as compared to one pumpkin. The pumpkin having a more weight as compared to one onion. Dear students, we purchase some of the objects in the market as for their need to our family. For example, chili, we can purchase the, we can buy the chili. It is in a small quantity. So for example, we can purchase or we can buy the chili only 200 grams or 250 grams only. But we can purchase the onions in 2 to 3 kg or 5 kg or more than 5 kg. And rice also, rice and wheat also we can purchase or we can buy in more quantity as compared to pulses. Because we can purchase rice or wheat more than 5 kg or 10 kg or more than 10 kg. But we can buy the pulses like dal, tur dal, moong dal, all are purchased only for 1 kg or 1.5 kg only. Because, dear student, we don't need all the things in the same quantity. We can need the different things in different quantities. Therefore, this is the small information about the weight of the object. The dear students, the gram is used to measure the small quantity or less weight of the objects. And kilogram is used to measure the large quantity of the objects or more heavy weight objects. Okay, dear student, this is the small information about the weight units, that is gram and kilogram. What is the relationship between gram and kilogram? Dear student, 1 kg is equal to relation between gram and kg is 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Dear students, 1 kg is equal to how many grams? 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. Okay, this is the relationship between gram and kg. You do the some word problems and also conversion of units for your higher standard. This is the small information for your syllabus. Only you know the units of measurement of the weight. You can identify which one is the more weight object and which one is the less weight object. Okay. So this is the relationship. We can learn the more information of the conversion of units for your higher standard. Then go to the third concept, that is measurement of a value. Okay. Measurement of value. This is the third concept of the measurement chapter. Dear student, measurement of value, the value, another name is capacity. We call it as a capacity also. The capacity and value both are same. Don't confuse. I use capacities also. Don't confuse. Value and capacity both are same. Dear students, the measurement of value, it is possible only for liquids. Dear students, the value is used only for liquids, not for solids and gases. Okay, dear students, the volume of measurement is only for liquids like water, milk, kerosene and etc. Are there any type of liquid we can measure by volume? We call it as a volume measurement. Value measurement is only for the liquids. Dear student, in the measurement of value, we can also use, there are mainly two standard units, that is milliliters and liter. Dear student, milliliter and liter. These are the two standard units to measurement of a value. Dear student, milliliter is represented as a ml and liter is represented as a small letter l. Milliliter is represented as a ml and liter is represented as a l. Dear student, when we use milliliter, milliliter is used to measure the small quantity of liquids. Dear student, we can use milliliter unit in case of measurement of a small quantity of liquids. And the liter is used to measure the large quantity of liquids. Okay, these are the main difference and difference between milliliter and liter. We can use milliliter to measure the small quantity of the liquids, and we can use to measure large quantity of liquids, we can use liter. For example, the milliliter. Dear students, I give some situations we can measure milliliter and also liter. The kerosene present in a drum. Dear students, the kerosene is present in a drum. Drum, it is one of the more quantity of kerosene is present within the drum. That's why we can use liter, because the kerosene present in the drum, it is in large quantity of kerosene is present within the drum. That's why we can use liter. And milliliter, the cup of milk. Dear student, the 1 cup of milk, it is a small quantity of liquid. That's why we can use milliliter. Did you understand, student, what is the main difference between milliliter and liter? The milliliter is used to measure small quantity of liquid. For example, the cup of milk or cup of tea or the syrup, medicine present within the syrup water, all are we can use to measure in milliliters. And liter is used to measure the large quantity of liquid. For example, the kerosene present in a drum, or water present in a syntax, or water present in the water tank, all these are we can use to measure in a liter, because in these situations the water or liquid present in a large quantity. That's why we can use liter. Okay, these are the main difference between milliliter and liter. Dear student, don't forget, only remember that the volume is measured only for liquids like kerosene, water and milk and any other type of the liquids only. Okay, so what is the relationship between milliliter and liter? Dear student, it is also having one of the relation between liter and milliliter. Dear student, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters. This is the main relationship between liter and milliliter. You do the some of the word problems and also conversion problems for your higher standard. You know the only relationship between liter and milliliter. Okay, the 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Dear students, today we discuss the measurement of length, weight and volume of the object. What are the units of measuring a length, weight and volume, and also relationship between the units. Okay, dear students, you learn more information and also more problems of the conversion of units for your higher standard. Only you remember the relationship and also what are the units of measuring a length, weight and value for only 3rd standard for your syllabus. Okay, I take the next concept, that is time. The time is very important role in our life. So the next concept we can learn, that is time. Okay,